Well, Sean, we just lost 4-0 today at Sparry. I suppose as matches go, it couldn't get any worse, could it?
Yeah, you can say that again. You lose your second choice keeper in the warm up with a dislocated finger, a freak injury, so he rules himself out. You lose Jamie Crowther after 15 minutes, after going 1-0 down, after 30 seconds or whatever it may have been. It might have been longer, I'm not entirely sure. So you're thinking it's just going to be one of them days. However, I've identified it at half time, and from minute 2 to minute 40 or 41 until the second goal, we were brilliant. We played some very good stuff in the final third. We've got in a few times. Our interchange was very good up top, to be fair, you know, into Breezy, and then said to Noah and Evo, get into the box as much as you can, you know, make good players like Troy Greening and Clayton Green track you and defend you, and they did. Darren, Sean Bradley, the other side, it was good, and then just giving it away sloppily, middle third, and hit on the counter-attack for the second goal. And you find yourselves 2-0 down after what was a really good reaction and a good performance. Two poor goals, but a good performance. And then the third one, you know, the big man has held his hands for that. Just a rare mistake. You know, we're in March, and that's probably Gaz Edwards' first mistake this year. But he's apologised there at the end. But you know, Gaz has been absolutely colossus for the team and for me since I've come in, so I'm not pointing a finger at Gazza at all. You know, John Hood's gone through for three, and then hint of offside maybe for the fourth, but again it was just giving it away sloppily after playing some really good football. 4-0 down, then a man down as well, and yeah, unfortunately it's going to make a 4-hour trip seem like an 8-hour trip now, unfortunately. But no, it was weird the goings on, I've got to admit. You know, credit to my lads, they've gone right to the end. We've had some words at the end, not telling off or anything like that, but you know, players, as players and as a group, we've got to take responsibility. And yeah, it's a 4-0 scoreline. You know, credit to Barry, they were clinical, given the opportunities. I think they fit the post and hit the bar, but looking back, I don't think Rambo's had a save to make, and that's what makes it weird, like, you know. But yeah, you know, full credit to them, and yeah, it's just a bad day at the office really for us.
After that first goal went in, Sean, was it then a case that we left ourselves a bit open by, you know, by pushing forward maybe too much?
Yeah, possibly. That's a good point, Paul, really. You know, for the longer you're chasing the game, you know, the more sort of like susceptible you are to a counter-attack. And, you know, I think Bala found it like the other week. We just didn't take advantage of the counter-attacks and the players involved in the counter-attacks. They're pushing men forward for an equaliser. And then when we win the ball back, we look to hit them. We just didn't take advantage of it. But, you know, Barry today, you know, credit to them. The likes of Kay McLaggan, you know, Mo Torre, John Hood, you know, they're just blistering in an instant. The ball will be turned over like middle third and then bang, like they're in, and that's what we found. You know, Mo Torre is a Football League player, so given the opportunity, he's going to finish. But, you know, other than that, we've had opportunities. Breezy's had a couple in the first half. Noah's little half volley. We managed to get contact on a couple of set pieces with Gaz Edwards, and, you know, he was unlucky, like, with them. You know, Danny Brookwell has given us fresh impetus down the left-hand side, as has Kai when he's come on, and we managed to get shots away. But, yeah, no, it's one of them days. It wasn't our day today. And, you know, like I said, full credit to Barry on the victory and the 3 points.
And any news on Jimmy's injury?
Whose injury, sorry?
Jamie Crowther.
Crowther, yeah, he's had trouble with his medial ligament before. He was telling me on the bench. I mean, I didn't mind it in a sense. I'd love him on the field, but, you know, to turn round, you know, to have him to, you know, have a chat with was better for me, obviously, in Fisher's absence. But, yeah, Crowther's just had a little turn, I think it was, centrally. We'll monitor that next week. Not serious. I hope it's not serious anyway, but it did seem serious. Got a little bit of ice on it, and yeah, he's a very very sort of like professional sort of player. He does everything professionally, Crowther, so he won't rush back. But if it's not too bad, he'll get himself back fit, absolutely no problem.
After this kind of defeat, Sean, I'm sure you'll be itching to get back, and the yeah. players will be itching to get yeah. back. You know, would you prefer a game sort of tomorrow?
Yeah, we would. Maybe not after a 4-hour trip home, but yeah, 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 we'd like a game, obviously, of course we would. But yeah, we'll look to that next week. It's nobody's fault, obviously, it's the way the fixtures have panned out, obviously, with it being Welsh Cup semi-final week next week. And, you know, on record, you know, I want to wish Barry all the best in that. It's, you know, it promises to be two very good semi-finals. But yeah, no, obviously we go into another break, so something in midweek next week would be ideal for us. And then we go into the home stretch then, which is another thing that I've addressed, you know, with the players in there. Home stretch, four very tough games, you know, all Friday nights, but two home games remaining. And we really, we want to put on the show, which I think we do, you know, every week. But, you know, for the fans who travelled again, like, you know, in their numbers today, we really want to perform like for our supporters, because they've been different class this year, and we'll be going all out to get two victories in our last two home games, that's for sure. A little bit of confidence going into the TNS game, looking at the table, if Connors Quay and, you know, even Barry now, they continue to push TNS, it could be a title defining game against TNS, so that puts the onus on us. But we'll be going there to win the game. We've won there already this year. And then we finish obviously like with Bala. So four tough games remaining, obviously going into the playoffs. We want to go into it like full steam ahead. So yeah, disappointing today, but yeah, we'll look forward to the end of the season now, hopefully.
And you were sure, Mark Kekanadek. What's your date?
I'm a Beckin and Gweithio and Galad. I'm a now deg minute. You know, deg at Llan Lyfeg. O goliau. Goal in at all, Ian Vinid, you know, pimp at and egg, and he's pimp Vinid, he's Hannah Ramsay, a goal, Clerk at and egg, maybe. I won't throw gas under the bus like with it, but you know, the mistake, it's one of them things, it happens. And then, yeah, Pedwerydd, goal, you know, giving the ball away cheaply, it's not good, you know, maybe another four or five generously, but yeah, goals were disappointing. You know, I've urged the lads to watch the clips, watch the 90 minutes as well, because I think over the course of the 90 minutes we've played really well. There was, I think, 15 minutes to go, and I think one of the stewards has come behind me like after a break in play, and he said, I really don't know how you're losing this game, you've played the better stuff, and you still find yourself sort of three or four down. So yeah, it's quite difficult to take, you know. I'm sure Gav may have said the same. However, they played some good stuff and they punished us, and they were clinical in that, Barry. So, you know, like I said, full credit to them, and taking nothing away from Barry at all. Full credit to them for the victory. We wish them all the best next week in the Welsh Cup semi-final. You know, I'll speak on behalf of Carnarvon Town. As for us, we'll dust ourselves down, because I've got an honest group of lads, and like you said, Paul, they're going to want to put it right. So we'll work hard next week, and yeah, we'll prepare meticulously again for Connors Quay at home 2 weeks on Friday.
Great. Diolch ti, Sean.
Dim problem. Diolch, Paul.